each was over 7 meters high with 6 columns at either end and 15 long lengths. The floor plan is of the Doric style and its entire length equals 174 foot, which is 53 meters by 70 foot, which is 21 meters. The Doric columns are monolithic, that is made from single pieces of stone. The stone used was limestone and had a surface of white marble stucco. Stucco is a fine plaster used for coating wall surfaces. Each of the columns is over 7 meters, that is 23 feet high, and at the base it has a diameter of 1.7 meters. 7 of these columns remain standing with a section of the entablature, which is the horizontal lintel on the building that's supported by the columns. And this is intact, resting on the top of the columns.
So the curvature of the stylobate, which is basically the base supporting the rows of columns, meant that the convex flooring of the temple allowed for the structure to be more symmetrical than, to look more symmetrical than it actually was. And the temple of Apollo at Corinth is probably the only other example of this. The temple of Apollo at Corinth is probably the earliest example of this addition to temple building. The Parthenon in Athens is another example of this innovation. However, while it is unknown when the temple was actually built, most scholars tend to believe that it was somewhere in the mid-6th century. Moreover, it is also clear that the temple which was built at this time was not architecturally identical to the one which stands here today. The inner buildings comprise of 2 rooms or cellars placed back to back. Each of these cellars were entered by a porch, each of these 2 columns, each with 2 columns in front of them. In the cellars were 2 rows of smaller columns. One theory is that just as the original temple had contained a treasury, the smaller room carried out the same function. This is particularly likely considering the fact that Hollinshed's, one of these people working on these temples, asserted that acting as a treasury was the primary function of most of these inner rooms of Greek temples. Another way in which these small rooms have been interpreted is for worship of a second divinity, with the belief that the western chamber housed a cult of Artemis, the sister of Apollo. However, some scholars believe that it is more likely that only a single god was worshipped at this temple and that the smaller room acted as a temple.
According to the Greek traveler Pausanias, who probably wrote his descriptions between 155 and 180 AD, there was a bronze statue of Apollo in the temple. In the Greek period, large steps to the east of the temple led down to the Lycaon Way and to the entrance to the Agora. Moreover, as has already been mentioned, the divinity to whom the temple belonged has long been debated. Many have identified it as the Temple of Apollo due to the geographical description given by Pausanias. However, there's very little evidence aside from this which identify the temple as such.
Additionally, even if the temple did belong to Apollo, possible effigies remain a mystery, with Pausanias only mentioning a gold statue and no other details. Thus, the cult practice which would have occurred there is completely unknown.